students are entire state, not only just state institution, the entire state is celebrating, and we are appreciating the contribution, what has been contributed for the growth of the state of Karnataka and as well as the entire country and for the entire world, the GAIL institution contribution is really amazing. And more so, today is much more special, and it happens to be the birthday of our Dr. Kendra Saab also. I would like to congratulate him, wish him all the best wishes. God give him more and more energy to bring in a bigger reform, bigger changes, a big transformation in our society through the education field. Probably that's the best thing what we can do. Any transformation we can see in the society, it can happen only through education, nothing else. So education is the key foundation to witness any growth, any good things happen in any field, whether it be agriculture, from agriculture to any culture, any area, any field, education is the cornerstone. So fully understanding this, we need to channelize whatever resource is available in our society with our hand. We need to promote education and strengthen education. The rounded personality, we keep talking about the rounded personality and the employability. In this direction, the GAIL Institute has been emphasizing a lot on sports, culture, diversity, social projects. All these things have been inculcated in the each and every student, probably making them a part of all the challenges what society has been facing. That has transformed each and every student of this institution. Whatever the society challenges have been facing with regard to the pandemic or many other issues, always will be in the forefront with all the students. So that is the right way of involving. In our state also, we are ensuring the student, the complete learning will happen unless we don't involve the students to be part of the, all the challenges or the problems, then we can't really ensure that the, what education they've been getting, it's not for any good purpose or the in the interest of the society. So I had one, I would like to quote one example, sir. During this pandemic, we have more than 10,000 students in the final year, doing final year MBBS. We asked them to be part of the telecalling. Telecall, step one was taken at that responsibility of organizing the telecall. After requesting the 10,000 students, probably we got only, we needed 1,000 students. And each of the students, their responsibility was to call 30 people, COVID infected people, they need to call 30 people each day. When they were asked to do that, only 100 people came forward. Imagine medical students, among the medical students, only 100 students are coming forward to call the COVID infected people. Only 100 people are making 30 calls. Just remaining, nobody took interest. The people were supposed to get involved and treat the patients. They themselves are not being responsible. They don't understand their responsibility. What can we expect from this? Just for their livelihood, they have come here, not to address the challenges or the problems faced by society. The entire education becomes meaningless. So, when we offered money to them, incentive was given, we got much more numbers than expected. So this is the state of affairs, so we need to understand the value-based education should be given to these children. In this direction, we are emphasizing a lot and ensure that they get the right education with the right understanding, what needs to be done, what they are getting back, they need to give back to the society. This is not understood. The very purpose of establishing all these institutions doesn't mean anything. So I wish you all the best, sir, as a higher education minister. And on behalf of the government of Karnataka, I am just representing all the governments so far to congratulate you and recognize your good work, whatever under your leadership, the entire team has done to the state. Thank you. Namaskar.